Hi, is that Gary?
Yes.
Hi, this is Tony from Fact Magazine in Bahrain.
Oh yeah, how's it going?
Yeah, it's going well, thanks. You know, I've been doing a fair amount of research on you guys recently and seeing all the, you know, the awards you've won, the, you know, like how much work you've been doing and the people you've collaborated with. I suppose first off, I have to ask, where did the name Japanese Popstars come from?
Originally it started off with like a bit of respect towards Japan and the original movies, the manga cartoons and stuff like that.
Yeah.
So, and the fact then was we were showing a bit of our Irish humour, because it was 5 or 6 years ago when it started. So, we're realistically not from Japan and we're not pop stars. So we're like the furthest thing you can get from that.
How did you guys originally get together to form the group?
Well, it originally started off, I was producing some music and also promoting some clubs back home in Derry. Two of the tracks were picked up by Ministry of Sound and we were offered a live show off back of one of the tracks by a promoter.
Okay.
We like hunted them down and made them do a live show.
Okay.
That'll be 4 months to put together a live show and we got 5 or 6 gigs off the back of the first gig and we just kept chancing our arms from there, doing remixes and building up a nice profile.
How would you describe it? It's very electro, very sort of...
We like a lot of things, different tastes. We were trying to express it through our music, so it's a lot of loud noises. We like chemical flowers, underwords, stuff like that, and we just try and say we write how we feel at the time and what we're feeling and enjoying, and hopefully it reflects the music.
Would you say, like, you know, some of those early big beat people, you know, Underworld, Chemical Brothers, like Fatboy Slim, people like that, are they like influences on you? Are they stuff that you, stuff that you listen to?
Yeah, definitely. Like a HMV or a music shop, if you're slotted beside those guys, very much appreciated.
And it must be quite nice getting paid to be at the festivals this time around, like, you know, at this stage.
Before, we would just get on the festivals for free, just by playing, so we... having to spend a few hundred pounds in the ticket.
Well, now that you've been playing festivals and gigs all over the world now, which sort of, which destinations or which festivals really stick out for you as your favourites, the ones that you, you know, remember and, you know, wouldn't mind going back to?
I would have to say Fuji Rock in Japan is definitely one that sticks out, first and foremost. We did a really special festival last year in Ireland, Electric Picnic, and it was our first time playing like one of the main dance arenas, and we weren't expecting it to be busy, but the tent ended up being rammed, so it was a bit of a moment for us. Obviously Glastonbury, the sheer size of it, and festivals, another one. We had a really good festival today at Reading, Creamfield Global Gallery. Now it's a good start. But it's just brilliant to have that opportunity to see those parts of the world and play those festivals. We played the Sundance Festival in Dubai about 2 months ago, and it was Mortiva, Travis, Henty Strider, Zane Lowe, and Fatboy Slim. It was really, really cool to be on that lineup. It was just, and see Dubai, it's like a whole different world.
See, you've collaborated with a fair few artists for your latest album, Controlling Your Allegiance. Which of the artists were really like fun or cool to work with?
We enjoyed working with every one of the artists, but Robert Swift, actually, he was really, really nice and he made it very, very thorough about what exactly he wanted, and he gave us so many parts and played a 6-string bass on the track.
You're playing all the major festivals, you're doing collaborations with some pretty impressive artists and doing a lot of remixes, getting a lot of sort of coverage and attention. How does it feel to be enjoying this sort of success?
And then we still see ourselves as clubbers, so we'll still do our shows. That's where we come from.